Hi guys, in this video I'm going to talk about madaline training algorithm. In madaline training algorithm, it involves 8 steps starting from step 0. So in the step 0, initialize the weight. In the step 0, we initialize the weight. The output is set to 1 and the small value for madaline weight. We have talked about perceptron training algorithm, madaline training algorithm. In both of the training algorithm, we do not set output value, but in madaline training algorithm we set the output equal to 1, and in madaline training algorithm we set small values for madaline weights. We set small value for madaline weight. This was the step 0. In step 1, when stopping condition is false, perform step 2 to 8. You need to check some stopping condition, like the calculated weight and the actual weight. That is, here we set the output equals to 1. So whatever we calculate the output, if it is equivalent to 1, then we can say stop the process. If this condition is false, then perform step 2 to 8. Step 2, for each bipolar training pair S is to T, perform 3 to 7. Here S is to T is for each input unit corresponding to the output unit. Keep in mind that for every training algorithm, S is to T is for each input unit is to output unit. So for each input unit to output unit, we have to perform from step 3 to step 7. In step 3, activate input layer unit for I is equals to 1 to N, Xi is equals to Si. So in step 3, we activate the input layer. So when you are training any neural network, then you need to activate the inputs, because if the inputs are not activated, then we cannot move forward and perform the weight updation. So in step 3, we activate the input layer units. Whatever the input layer units are there, from 1 to N, we activate each input unit Xi is equals to Si. Xi is the input signal value. In step 4, since this madaline training algorithm works in two phases. First phase is from input to madaline layer, from madaline to madaline layer. So first part is we calculate the net input for the madaline layer, that is our hidden layer. Calculate the net input to each hidden madaline unit. We have talked that in madaline we have many numbers of madaline units. So for each madaline unit we calculate the net input. We have seen that if there are 3, 4, 5, 6, so many numbers of neurons, so then from each neuron a weight correspond to particular neuron or unit in the madaline. So we need to calculate net input for each madaline unit. Means for this Z is equals to 1, for Z is equals to 2, so on. So in step 4, calculate the net input to each hidden madaline unit. And how this net is calculated? Z i and j means it corresponds to first madaline unit, and from this first madaline unit number of weights and signals are passed to this madaline unit from the input unit. So Z i and j is equals to bj, that is bias value, plus summation of xi wi. Summation of xi wi is, that is xi is the input signal and wi is the corresponding weight. So for each unit we calculate the net input in the step 4. In step 5, calculate output of each hidden unit. Once you have the net input for each hidden unit, now you will calculate the net output of each hidden unit. And each hidden unit output is calculated as ZJ is equals to function ZING. Since we know that Adeline unit is a bipolar function, so this value is passed to the function present in the Adeline layer and the output is calculated. Now you have output of each of the hidden unit, like you have the output for Z equals to 1, Z is equals to 2 and so on. Now find the output of the net. Now once you have calculated the output of each Adeline unit, now in the step 6 you will calculate the output of the net, that is total complete network. And how we are going to do this? First we will calculate the net input for the output unit. And how this net input for the output unit is going to calculate? Like there are suppose two units, then ZI is the signal and VI is the corresponding weight. Then we will multiply ZJ with VJ and this will give, and total summation will give us the net input to the output unit. And once you have the net input, then you will put in the activation function and you will calculate the output. This was the step 6. Now the main step. In step 7, calculate the error and update the weight. In step 7, we calculate the error and update the weight. And in Madaline, weight updation take place only in the Adeline layer. So suppose T is the target value and Y is your calculated value. Your target value and your calculated values are equal, then no weight change, then we will not change the weight. Suppose your target value is not equals to Y and your target value is plus 1, then your weight updation take place as Wij new is equals to Wij old plus alpha 1 minus Xij into Xi. This Xij is the net input to the hidden unit and Xi is the initial input signal. So since this Madaline consists of Adeline, and we know that in Adeline network we update the weight with the help of delta rule or you can also called Weidorf-Hopf rule. So the weight updation take place with the help of delta rule. But there is a change, that if your target value is plus 1 or either your target value is minus 1. If your target value is plus 1, then this value is 1, and if your target value is minus 1, then this target value is considered to be minus 1. And similarly bias is also updated. In step 6, in step 8 we test for the stopping condition. Now the stopping condition is checked, like T is equals to Y, this is our stopping condition. If the target value and the calculated value are equal, then we have to stop our training algorithm. If our T is not equivalent to Y, then we again start from the steps 2 to 8 and this process goes on until the stopping condition is not true. So this was all Madaline training algorithm. Thank you.